Yeah.
which need not to cover. So I'll directly start with the projects only, and if important some of the roles comes up within the flow, I'll cover that up and all the other security related stuff. So as you know, PPM is using project-based implementation, which you might have worked. So wherever there is involvement of project and the involvement of the managing the project cost, managing the project in a much granular way, project is really helpful. So in PPM, we talk about project execution management and project financial management primarily. Project execution management is just for the project management part. It covers project task management, and project resource management. But the real important things comes in project financial management. Here we cover the financial aspects of the PPM, which includes primarily, or if I give them on a very high level, project costing and project billing. So these two comes in the project financial management. So under this, we have further project foundation, project control, project contracts and billing, and SLA accounting, etc. So as you can see here, as the slides talks about, the PPM cloud actually consists of budgets and forecasts, cost control, billing, cost management, project management, task management, resource management, analytics and insights, the past part of the PPM. Now, this budget and forecast, cost control, billing and revenue, these three comes in the project financial management. Grants also comes in project financial management. Grants is enabled. This is for the implementations where the grants is involved. Project management, task
An example
management.
of grants.
Grants is for the universities where they are getting a grant from some another source, which is only very like rare scenario you will encounter grants management. Is it will only be encountered where I say government funded university or it's a institution NGO which is being funded, which is getting funded from some source. So that source, that whole thing is called as grant, that they're getting a grant for project, and that comes in grants management. So anyhow, grants management is very rare, like less than 1%.
Sorry.
Less than 0.1% you'll be getting implementations for grants management. So this is not a part, not part of the scope of this peer training, grants management. We are covering project financial management primarily here, and if we have time, we'll also cover a few bits about project execution management as well. So project management, task management, resource management comes under project execution management, and analytics and insights are the part of OTBA. Capture now.
So, as part of this course that we are going to cover, are we going to cover grants or we are going to exclude grants?
Now we're going to not cover grants.
Okay. No, I just wanted to understand. Otherwise, we'll cover everything, right?
Yeah.
Financial management and exit. Okay.
We have 90% will be focusing on the financial one, 10% will be focusing on the execution one.
Okay,
That's
so
how every PPM training actually goes out everywhere.
okay, so when it comes to execution management, that is where we define the WBS structure and all, right? We define
No.
the budget structure.
No. That is in project financial management. It comes in.
Okay.
Execution management is nothing but you have normal project management plans, right, to you make for your project.
So we do the scheduling and all from execution management.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Yeah. So as for this slide talks about all the previous processes within the PPM cloud, and we're gonna cover each and everything one by one. Like first we're gonna talk about capture project cost. Now, capture project cost means it comes under project costing. So if it has to come under project costing, it means you have to have the role of a project accountant here. Only project accountant have the desired access to is only with the project accountant. If any person has given the access of project accountant, will get the project costing part. He'll be able to enter the time card, he'll be able to enter the transactions, he'll be able to process those transactions, count those transactions, send them to GA, etc. There's a lot of disturbance going on.
No, I am able to hear you clearly.
Something Tuck is going on a lot of. So now to make sure the project costing part works properly, we have to make sure that project initiation part, which is creation of the project, etc., has been completed successfully. That means project has been created. It also means project control part has been completed successfully. In project control, this is just a demo as of now. I'm not covering everything in detail, so going in a bit of flow. In project control, we talk about budgets and forecasts. So that means budgets and forecast part has been completed successfully. Budgeting has been done. Project is assigned a budget. Project is ready to capture the cost. So, and accounting is in place. So if all things are there, we are ready to capture the project cost. We can capture the project cost. Project cost can be captured from the project itself, which we call as pre-approved batches. We call it miscellaneous. We can capture by miscellaneous expenditures, time cards, or usages, whichever expenditure type class we want to use. Or we can get it interfaced from other modules like P2P or time card. Like we can get purchasing receipts, we can get invoices interfaced to the projects. Now, this comes as a cost to the project, which can further be utilized on the project for either capitalization if the project is going in a capital, if the project is capital project we have created, or we can further build this project if the project is to be built to a customer using that cost.
When it comes to P2P, is it only expenses or inventory items also coming here?
As of now, in Fusion, we can interface inventory as well from the manufacturing, but from the inventory, there's no budgetary control applied. That means any cost can go more than the budget amount, because as of now, that project manufacturing is not delivered by Fusion to the PPM space. That project manufacturing will come rather after one or two years, as per my last check with the product development. It's not in the pipeline. No ETA has been given, but still they have given a rough idea about 1 or 2 years. So then only.
Yeah, I was in LA for Open World, Oracle Open World, which happened just 2 weeks back, and we were talking to the product development team there. They said they did a demo to our group basically, and they gave us the big picture of when they're planning to implement this project manufacturing. This tentatively 2020 is what they are looking at. Yeah. So when project manufacturing is not there, and you said that inventory is possible, but there is no control over budget, that means can I have my BOM defined and then I'm trying to understand that side of it. I am not expert in BOM and all, but I'm trying to understand if I have a BOM where, you know, I'm in a construction line of business, and I have some material that I procure from outside, and then I have my own inventory where I source the material. So can I implement that without project manufacturing with the existing?
That you do in the inventory part, manufacturing part, not in the project manufacturing. And from the project's perspective, if any item has been assigned to the project via move order or via project transfer, so that gets transferred to the projects or you do a miscellaneous issue. So that goes transferred to the project as a cost on the project.
Okay, but we cannot track the material, where the material is, and
nothing. We just get the cost. That's it. And we can see the which from the source and the name of the item. That's it.
Okay. So yeah, so that is what you get in manufacturing, right? If you have project manufacturing where you can track the material, and then if you have revisions, then you can track the revisions.
Yeah.
Okay. And I mean, before we, I'm sorry, I'm asking too many questions, but before we move on, I'm just curious to understand. I don't know how this works, or if you have any document references which talks about the steps and process of how this actually works in on-prem, that is release 12 or release 11. If you have any documentation with BOM and you know, this structure, will you be able to share that during any time?
I'll try to find it, because it's been more than 3.5 years I work on EBS on-premise. I have to check those. If I have, I will send it to you.
Yeah, from my side, I tried to get to that documentation, but I could not. But I know how this the configurations are done, how the setups are done, so that the BOM, you do the auto task assignment in the project manufacturing, so that all the tasks are same as what you have in the projects, and the costs are interface to projects, so that you have control on the budgets, and you can do revisions in project manufacturing, so that the revised cost and revised budget, you see the reflection in the budgets.
Yeah, I'll try to find that out. If I have the document, I'll send that to you. I'll check with one of my friend as well. If there is a document available with him as well, I'll send that to you. It's been long time we worked on EBS, so it's really hard to track those documents. I'll have on my hard disk somewhere. I'll send it to you.
Okay. And did you get an opportunity to work in similar project where there is a requirement for this kind of structure, BOM structure, and you have used a third party vendor where you did an integration with a third party vendor to Fusion?
No, there was not an implement. There was an upgradation we did actually in the manufacturing side, Thermax India.
So that was on cloud, PPM?
No. On cloud, we don't have right project manufacturing.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about project manufacturing, but there are wide variety of third-party systems in market today where they are integrating with cloud PPM to bring in this functionality of BOM until,
In PPM cloud, Oracle is pushing not for any customization or anything like that. But if there's a third-party integration available, is there? But I don't think I might have encountered that so far.
So how are now? I'm just asking, like, how are other customers managing this portion of tracking? I mean, I know most of the construction project-driven companies use PPM, and if they are project-driven, they would definitely have this kind of structure, right? BOM-related structure.
Even if they have the structure, mm-hmm. right? But they have to. First of all, you can't enable the locators in the project mm-hmm. and task locator. You can't mm-hmm. track this item is for which project and which task at that level. You only have RORAC pin as a locator. Plus, also for the transaction sources, inventory, etc., there's no budgeting control. So really, very less we can do here. Maximum we can do here is to enable web services from the project, because those only web services are available from the PPM side that can interface the cost directly without even having any client input to the project.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Any other web services to track that web services has to be available from the third party application as well, and the projects as well. In the projects, I doubt if there's any web services available to track the anything else apart from managing the cost. You can do creation of the project, managing of the project, etc., managing tasks, etc., but with the its integration with the BOM and managing that BOM, I don't think any web services is also available. Do a third-party integration as well.
Okay. So if this manufacturing is not there, then do we have any control on the WIP? Like, most of the customers, they want to park their transactions cost to WIP and then to COX. So how do that flow work then? So do we need to build some SLA rules to account in that manner?
There I haven't worked so far in the project because project manufacturing is not there, so we really can do much about there, and we rarely do any customization or enhancements to the client because that's not part of like a cloud policy. We work on no customization, no enhancement way. I haven't worked on so far any such scenario like involving project manufacturing much. Because project manufacturing is not there, so for a hell, really any implementation is also coming on that side.
Okay. So you said there is SLA here. So do we just use that for accounting, or do we also can we also build the rules there so that, you know, I can use my, like, you know, the way you customize SLA in on-prem release 12, right? You know, you can build your own accounting rules. Is that what we do in SLA in projects, or is it just auto accounting kind of thing?
See, SLA as you have in API as well, right? There's rules available, mapping sets available, everything is available. It's similar to that.
Okay, cool. Let's move on. Yeah, now I'm trying to get there. Okay.
So this talks about the project lifecycle. Starting with the like if any sales opportunity, it also covers the project execution management and project financial management. So you can see the above row talks about the project execution management, and downward row talks about the project financial management. And once the project is created, you can with using project execution management, you can manage the project and task. And you can also manage the resources that we can assign to that project using the project execution management. And this whole can also be done via project financial management as well. But in project financial management, we can also cover budgets and forecasts, billing related stuff, SLA, managing cost, all those other important tasks which are important for every implementation or which are important for every client. So as you can see here, a contract manager is a role that is that need to have for any person to be able to create the contract, to manage the contracts. For the managed cost, project accountant is a role that is required. For the billing and revenue, not for revenue, for the majorly invoicing, for the billing, we'll need billing specialists. Revenue creation rule comes automatically since R13 to the project accountant itself. If you assign the role as project accountant, he will get managed costs as well as the revenue creation access as well for the projects that he's been assigned to. Okay. You also capture time and expense for all the workers working on the project. Will be able to get that project in the LOB to be able to capture the time they're working on that project, and that cost again will come to the project. And we have managed performance. We have a lot of 2-3 dashboards available in the projects, like from where we can track the project cost in form of charts and graphs, which really sells a lot with the client, because that's really good information for the clients to check on one single shot about the project, which is also customizable as well.
Okay. And you said capture time and expenses. Is it OTL that we are talking about?
Yeah, you can capture via OTL. It can be even third party as well, because from the third party again it's about cost, and we have that services available to capture the cost. So it can be any third party as well. It can be captured via Excel as well from the project itself.
Okay, so I'm just asking because are we going to see any sample web service during our training?
That's a technical training.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I mean, yeah, I understand it's technical.
Yeah.
Are we going to touch any few standard web services where we can use, and you can give some real-time scenarios that, you know, these are the web services that you can use to incorporate these kind of business scenarios?
I can give you those web services. I can list them all. But again, that has to be done by a technical person like edit it, create it, install it, test it.
Mm-hmm.
That is a long process.
Okay, so you know the process, so you can touch on that process. We will not execute it in the course, but you can touch on that process. Right?
No, I'm not sure about okay. that process because yeah, that's functional consultant. We only touch on technical part.
Okay.
We can touch upon the FBDA part, but not that web services. Yeah.
Yeah, you know what. So I play a dual role. Like, you know, I play a role of advocate for a client, and then there is an implementation partner who is doing a project right now. I don't want to name the name of the company, but those consultants, what they did, they just came to us with. I joined these guys a little late. Like, you know, this happened. The project and I joined. They came to client place with FBDI, AD FBDI templates, and they just started the project. Okay, and then now we took into a different direction, and it's becoming very difficult for them to move on. So I will tell you, like, and I will share those experience so that, you know, it will at least I will get some kind of inputs from you, and that will also help you you know, think through, you know, how to you know, solution at least from a very high level. We will not try to do that, but I will just share my experience so that, you know, while we are going through this course.
So they have like not in the right direction, you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, see, we are in the project close to 8 weeks now, and this client is 150% project driven.
Okay.
There is no way that they can go live without their project. The main thing is the sales team from the implementation partner side. They said project, the BOM and all is possible in cloud. Okay, and that was a selling point. So that's what they were able to sell, and then they pitched into the project. And then when the customer asked to demo that, and then they realized that there is project manufacturing piece itself is not available. That was a shocker to everyone. And now we are looking at a third party system to, via web services to integrate with the,
See, when I said BOM is not there, but I didn't say that it can't be done, because we in Oracle has a policy of no integration, no enhancement, no. Very, very few pass extensions, but implementation partners have no, restriction on that part. They can do it.
Yeah,
they can develop.
Heading towards that. Yeah, we are getting into that, and we are exploring few options. We try to, I think this sales orders flow is also not fully functional in current version of
cloud.
Yeah. So, and order management itself has a lot of issues and a lot of challenges, right? So these guys are trying to sell that part, but then I raised the concern that, you know, there are a lot of challenges there. You know, I don't know. In the R12, you can at least stop the invoicing. You can customize the workflow and then stop the invoicing from order management to AR, and then billing can happen from project. I don't know how that is going to happen in cloud.
Is the client on EBS already?
No. These guys are on non-ERP. They have different systems to manage different processes. So they are into small ERP, not ERP, but Salesforce Cloud, right? So they used Salesforce Cloud as a platform and built their own product on Salesforce Cloud. And the product is a one single template where you can do everything. You can do that is a project driven template. I can say I like the template so much that, you know, you can customize on fly, you can do BOM, you can do WIP, you can do everything that you can do in a project.
Okay, so see what I'm saying, because many of the clients I've seen, they are already on they are EBS, but they don't want to leave the EBS because they know there's some restrictions in the PPI in the cloud so far in many ways. So they're managing both with the integration with cloud to EBS.
Yeah, I know. So So I being financials consultant right now, I took this role because I am seeing a lot of opportunity to learn, at the same time a lot of challenges to face in this implementation. And by the time project manufacturing flies in and is readily available, I can scale up in these, because I am seeing a lot of implementations coming up in these areas, and there are a lot of customers who are interested to implement cloud PPM.
See, you went to the Los Angeles Oracle conference, and the thing is, they have told you 2020 over there.
Yeah.
But I don't know if they be at exactly 2020. So they could be, that could be 2021 as well.
We had that doubt, we had that same feeling. That's why didn't want to wait till 2020. So we took this route of customizing in the sense, integrating with the third party system.
Yeah, because see, when the order management came, many of the clients just stopped implementing it all, because order management had 1,000 issues when it came. Whatever you're installing is still a refined version of that so far.
Yeah, it's not
2 years back. 2 years back, it was even not at this stage that it is right now. So project manufacturing, I don't know how further iterations it will take to go back and forth when it will come. So whether it will have any issues or not at that point of time, because it's a complex portion, because it has integration with BOM and manufacturing and inventory everywhere. So it can be a scenario when it go back and again they'll give the final version in a new release.
So how are these, I mean, all these customers who are project driven customers, like, not the projects that you are working, how are they managing that? Are they just bringing the cost through miscellaneous issue?
They are. I've worked on a very, very big client. They had a lot of bill of materials there, because that is a telecommunication company, very, very big telecommunication company of Africa.
Okay.
So yeah, we had a restriction. We couldn't do anything about it.
So what was the solution? Like workaround?
From the projects, it is just a cost. That's it.
Miscellaneous
issue. We get that cost, miscellaneous issue. And from there, even the further problem is, we can't, if we want to capitalize that, right, we don't have client extensions for that.
Okay, yeah.
For example, if one item is being capitalized and customer want to track that item, this is the cost for that item, and capitalize that, those asset by item, each and individual item. In project costing, it's the sum of cost that gets capitalized. But to create individual assets, we have to do that by client extension. And in cloud, client extensions are also not delivered.
Yeah. Okay.
So we couldn't even confirm to the client whether we'll be able to do at least tracking their assets by the items, so that they'll be able to track individual cost of their items in the fixed asset, that this is what has come for, as an item. They could say we have the location, etc., but we can't. How can I can tell the client the location is there with asset and with the item when you're creating it? But there's no location reference available. Location reference is available in the project as well, but that doesn't mean anything. Project doesn't create assets based on location. It doesn't even have, is not even there in the end criteria of the query which picks up.
Yeah. These are some of the things that, you know, I would like to discuss and share. You know, if you can share, that will really help me.
But see, that's our problem with Oracle Consulting, because we don't do client extensions. Yeah. If you are I also use a cloud, right? Not on-premise Fusion, right? Your implementation.
Yeah, it's cloud. It's pure cloud.
Yeah, so even there, the same issue will be there. Client extensions are strictly not available. But
So these guys are not using capital asset, capital projects.
Billing, they're doing.
Yeah, so these guys are completely into contracting, project contracting, and they are using project contracts and project billing and overhead projects. So these are the two types of projects that we are going to create. One is contract projects and one is overhead projects. That's it. We are not using.
So they use burning billing. They are doing by events or by
events. So we are just very, you know, at a very initial stage. So that is the reason why I thought, you know, I will go through this course from some experts like you, and then I can give some kind of solid consulting advices to this customer and help them achieve what they are actually trying to achieve. I bluntly told to my VP, who is actually managing the entire program, that, you know, this, you guys are into project driven, and then the product that you have chosen is not a project driven product. So you will max, you will get 60 to 70% of what you are actually doing right now. So you should, you should try and see how you are going to get the remaining 40-50% by the time the project is completed. So that I have set that expectation to my boss as my role dictates. So I will leave it to them how they want to proceed. I think they will move on, because there is a lot of overseeing from Oracle, and Oracle Consulting, they do a weekly visit to client PS and then talk to them and trying to help them choose the best third party system, and then making use of web services, and then trying to help us there. And I will tell you what, these guys, they have a tracking forecasting mechanism, but I don't think so. The current we were talking about the scheduling, right? So the way they are doing the scheduling in their legacy system, I don't think so that can be done in Oracle, because I have seen that myself. We will talk about it when we get there, but the kind of scheduling that they are doing right now, it is mind-boggling. Like, you know, if you, when we get to that place in the system, while we are doing the configurations, I will tell you how these guys are doing the scheduling right now. And that is go, no go decision maker for this customer. These guys have close to 5,000 to 8,000 projects right now. And that is going to go beyond 10 to 20,000 next year. And this is one of the fastest growing company in North America, and they are planning to spread to Canada, and then I don't know about international, but that is a plan. So you can imagine, right, 4,000 to 5,000 projects scheduling in one shot by one manager.
Okay, in one shot they can schedule all the projects.
They will do all 4,500. In native projects, you have project and tasks, right? Tasks are vertical. You have a project, and then you have all the tasks below it, you know, top task to, whatever tasks you have. You have a project and you have tasks. But then the kind of scheduling, if I am a project manager of 100 projects, so, I mean, I cannot see that seeing in one page, one web page, right? Mm-hmm. So the way they have built that legacy system is, they have a horizontal view of tasks. If it is 100 tasks, 200 tasks, or 1,000 tasks, they can see horizontally. So all those tasks, you have only 2 days, forecast date and actual date. Mm-hmm. So each task has 2 dates below it, and then they have, on the extreme left side, they have all the projects in sequentially.
Okay.
So they just, in one click, they will just change the dates. And then the moment they change the date here, it gets reflected in the projects.
That can be achieved via the web services.
Yeah. These guys overcommitted, the implementation partners, they overcommitted, and now they are trying to build as a custom via web services. They are trying to do that. And there are challenges they are going through. So
because that's no way possible in BPM.
BPM
is not, it's one project by one project. That's it. There's no one go all the projects. Never, not at all, anywhere in the BPM.
Yeah. So though, that is one. So these are some of the challenges that we are going through, and I am seeing that nowhere this is possible in BPM.
But you have this third-party application. You can simply call the web service. It will be achievable.
Okay.
Scheduling, yeah. It will be achievable.
Yeah. Have you ever seen this kind of structure of scheduling in on-prem EBS?
We have Not for scheduling, but we have the same kind of problem when we had the previous client in which you're talking about total 3,000 projects. Here we used to have on one new initiation of something in new one new business opportunity for the client, they used to create 5,000 projects for that every new business opportunity. So you can talk about 5,000 projects being created at like daily basis.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
How the scheduling, how they used to do the scheduling project by project or the way
No,
I.
scheduling, we started by giving selling them, but then initially they dropped because with 5,000 projects, it was not at all possible to do that. Then it was just only project financial management. With project financial management, again, this asset issue I talked about with you, right? Again, that came up because they can't individually do that for each and every project. It's not physically possible. And web services and this client extensions are not available. So we had to make sure that we separate each and every task by its, like make sure the task structure is so good that whenever a cost get accumulated to the task, it will be only for that asset itself. And it will be one asset to one task kind of relationship.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So when we are doing this as part of implementation in our course, right, because we'll pick a complex scenario and try to build a project and structure from there.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, so complex structure, like the work structure should be complex, and then I can talk about what challenges I'm facing, and then that way you can at least guide me,
Yeah.
if not build a solution there, but you can give me some pointers and suggestions that I can explore. So from a configuration standpoint, I understand what are prerequisite setups that are required. But then I would really like you to focus on why we are using this, what other options are available, what kind of challenges you get if you choose certain options and certain not choose certain options. So that way I can get the best out of this, and then I can also share what I am actually hearing from these guys here.
No problem. Yeah, we'll cover the complex scenarios. Even we'll cover the complex scenarios in the project billing as well, in which rather than showing one project, one contract, and one to one, we will do multiple funding and multiple projects for every contract to see how the invoice is getting generated for that as well.
Okay, and I know we are. I don't know what is your schedule right now. So you are in India or you are somewhere here, US, with us?
No, I'm in India as of now, but within 15 days I'll be traveling for some time to Singapore for 1 week. Yeah, but I'll
So
be
you
in India.
think we'll be able to complete before your travel?
Possibly, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
Yeah.
it's a lot of
Okay.
time. Still 15 days is there. I think we should be able to complete that before travel.
Okay,
Yes.
so I don't know about your schedule right now. I think we can. You want to cover something? We can cover.
I think this time suits best for me as well. So it was 7 a.m. in for me, and 7 to 8 or 7 to 8:30 will be best time we can cover that, right?
Yeah. I mean, I can stretch. I can stretch 2 to 3 hours if you want. Like, if you want, I don't know when you start to work, but I understand, you may have to travel to office, and
Yeah.
so I am flexible. Like, 7 a.m. your time is 8:30 p.m. my time.
Okay.
So 32, I mean, I'm expecting 2 hours a day. That is your 2 hours. That is you. If we start sharp at 7 and try to cover by na till 9, then I think we should be able to complete within 15 days. Into 20 days.
Yeah, let's do that. If someday I have to leave early, I'll leave by 8:30 because sometimes there are early meetings because the client is in Singapore. So we are they ahead of us. So sometimes we have early morning meetings as well.
Okay,
So
and will you also share the presentation that you are showing, and then any materials for my reference because during this course?
yeah, sure, not a problem.
Any configuration documents, any and I also asked you about the on-prem how this project manufacturing material piece works. If you have any documents, I'm not in a hurry, but you know, when you get to that document, if you can share that, will be appreciated.
Yeah, not a problem. Yeah.
So quickly, just walk through what we are going to cover as part of this course, like, you know, and infrastructure related, I will ask and I don't know if somebody else is in the call, like instance access and any documentation, any material that they are going to provide.
I will help you. Prasad, I will help you.
And may I know your good name, please?
Rama.
Okay. So I got your schedule, I mean, like the curriculum. So can we just quickly go through that and then close for today?
I will share you in separate email, okay, the course content, what is going to covering Vikas, okay?
No, I have share you that. I have that. I just want to hear from Vikas.
That will be the older one which they have on website.
Oh, okay.
Which you have the PPT of that or what?
Yes, I got a PPT. That's what I was actually looking at.
Yeah, that was sent by me only. Let me check.
Okay. Vikas, you shared same thing.
Yeah, that's what
you
I was.
You can open that same thing. Otherwise, I will open it. No issues.
No, I'm opening it. Just find
yeah, we'll just go through the contents and then we can close for today. And before closing, I can talk to Rama and then on the next steps. And
yeah, we'll start from tomorrow. We can cover role and accesses, yeah, which are important. We can mm-hmm. cover enterprise structure. This is the first one which we talk about when we create a like tomorrow straight away we start with the implementation. And we'll cover all the enterprise structures of projects, project financial management, department cost centers, project organization hierarchy, project units, project defining project organization classifications, etc. So this whole mm-hmm. a part of project foundation we're covering here. Again, okay, this whole is a project foundation. See, before project foundation, we have to cover project organization, which is part of the workflows structures, or workforce structure, not the workflow, workforce. So that's part of that. Then we have project foundation part. We have the project control part. Project foundation we cover till like you have RBS, you have schedules, you have project burdening, which you call it overhead, etc. Project control, we talk about period profiles, spread curve, financial plan types, project plan types, which is your WBS here.
Mm-hmm.
Project costing, we'll talk about the costing setup. If we want to talk about intercompany, we'll cover intercompany as well with the project billing. If you have, we have intercompany setup there.
Yeah. We have a very typical intercompany here. So we'll when we get into that, I will give you that scenario. We'll cover
intercompany and interproject billing, both the scenarios. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We'll cover the cross charge. We'll cover the OTL, data migration, OTBI for projects. Project billing setup is complete. Then we'll get down to project templates, project budgeting controls, project performance, accounting setup, SLA setup of that, and the transaction flow as well.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the setup part we have done. Then we come to the transactional flows of that.
And OTL setups, do we do any separate setups for OTL?
I can show you that, but there is not really any setup is required. If somebody, some consultant say, tells you he needs 1 week for OTL, tell them get a hike because it just take 1 hour. Excellent.
Yeah, that's what is happening now. You know, I know that OTL is not that too complicated. These guys are taking their own sweet time.
Yeah, I mean, like I can show you how OTL is done. It hardly takes 5 minutes soon.
Okay. Yeah. And I did not see OTBI and if there are any...
FPDI, OTBI for projects.
And dashboards, do we see any dashboards?
Dashboards, sandbox, etc. is required to be created. I'll cover that up. I'll if not, I'll share you documents which are step by step instructions for sandbox, etc.
Okay. If time permits, we will try to do one small dashboard, because I would like to know that, learn that, and then build, because I see a lot of situations where these guys may end up doing dashboards. And one more doubt I have, if I build a dashboard, say for example, for a particular scenario business function, and I can use that dashboard day in, day out, and if I make any changes in the dashboard, will that reflect onto the projects?
You mean to all the other people as well who are using the projects?
Yeah.
So dashboard can be made public for you or private for you. So depending on your how you are using it.
Mm-hmm.
If it's so public.
When I say transactions, if I change any cost of the project.
No, that'll be done on the system itself. Any change on the transaction will be there for every people as well. If you, so for example, change capitalizable indicator from yes to no, or billable indicator from no to yes. So that is done on the transaction. So anything done on transaction, which is in central hub, will be same be reflected on every other user who will use. Okay. Because you're modifying the transaction.
Right, right. And will we cover smart views? Are there any smart views for projects that I can build?
Not that I've seen.
Okay.
We have dashboard and we have viewlets available. Viewlets, you know?
Infolets?
Maybe you call viewlets as smart views only, because if you... Hello?
Yeah.
Voice was breaking.
Mm-hmm.
So if from the, in the home page, when you go to the next page, these are all the viewlets available.
Okay. Okay, yeah. We'll see that.
I think you call that as a smart view only, probably. We call it viewlet. Let me show you if I have some.
Okay.
Just give me a second. I'm opening an instance.
Smart views are, you get that as an Excel template, right? Those are for financials. I know that for sure. But I was wondering if there any, because that comes as part of a cube, Hyperion, it's a Hyperion tool, smart view.
No, that would not have that. I was talking about viewlet. We have viewlet here, but not the smart view.
Okay. Fantastic. I think we'll have a very good, healthy discussions. You can stop me if I am asking too many questions, but otherwise I would like to keep this interactive and then kind of.